You can see it has extracted, the script has extracted the zip file contents, and it has stored here. Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope you all are doing good. So today's topic of discussion will be about extracting zip files, and also the reverse, that is, you can convert a folder into a zip file. So first I will be discussing how to convert a zip file, or how to extract a zip file. For this, what I will be doing is I have a file, zip file. Okay, this is the zip file which I have, and what I will be doing, I will be making a script in order to convert, to extract the contents of this file and to store the contents here in this folder, unzip folder, which is here, which is on the desktop. Okay, so let's start. So for this we will be using an assembly which is in .NET. So we will be using that assembly, and we will be extracting. So PowerShell script, let's add a command to extract a zip file. And you may think that you have third-party tools also, and why I should use this. So third-party tools are, some are free and some are, some are licensed. You need to purchase it. But you already have a built-in function by using which you can extract files. So why to buy if you already have, and if you are using Windows? Okay. So I'm calling assembly, and the name of this assembly is system.io.compression.filesystem. And this is a commandlet or method by which we can add the assemblies in our PowerShell scripts. And now after adding this PowerShell script, it will alone not do anything. You have to convert it into an object first. So in order to convert an object, as I have discussed this, how you can convert an object by using a new object command also, but here we will not be using that command. So if you want to know that how you can add the assemblies in your PowerShell in more detail, then you can refer to my previous videos. The comments, the link I will mention in the description box, so you can go through that. It will be very interesting and you will really enjoy it. So this is the method which we will be using, extract to a directory. This will have two parameters. The first parameter will be test source, and second will be the the first parameter will be source, which will be the address of the zip file, and second will be the destination. The destination means where the contents you will contents of the zip file you will store or keep after the extraction, means after the zip file is extracted, where all the components, also all the contents will go. So let me create a variable, it's called zip file variable, and let me store the address of this zip file. This is the folder. Okay, so store, and this is the address of the zip folder. Second will be the destination. Let's store the destination address. Destination address is not here. Let me open the folder. This is the destination folder where we will be storing the content of the file, of the zip file. Now let's add the parameters, the variables. Enter the parameters. Destination. So I have done this. Now I'm going to run it, and you will see that the components of the the contents of this zip file will be extracted and will be stored here in this unzipped file. This is the highlighted one. Here it will be, all the contents will be stored. Okay, so let's run the script and let's see what happens. You can see it has extracted, the script has extracted the zip file contents, and it has stored here. And if you really want to verify it, you can verify also. So these are the contents inside the zip file, and these are the contents which are extracted. So this is the zip file, and this is the folder where the contents are stored. So you can tell it, you will find that all of both are the same. So this was about how to extract how to extract or you a zip file. Okay. Now let's discuss how we can do the reverse, that is how we can convert a folder into an zip file, or how we can compress a folder. That is reverse. So we will be doing the same thing. Okay, there will be just a difference in the method which we will call. So PowerShell script, let's add a to compress a file or convert it into zip file. So again we will do the same thing. There's nothing new in it. We are doing the same thing which we have done in the previous section. Here the method which we will be using is create from directory. So here it will also have two parameters. First parameter is again the source, and second the destination. Source here refers to the directory or the folder, the contents of which you want to compress. Okay, the folder which will be converted into a zip file. So first parameter will be the that, and second will be the address where you want to keep that zip file. Okay. So let's again create a variable where I will be storing the address of both the source and destinations. So this will be name it as compressed file path, which is this. What I am going to do is I will be referring to this unzip file folder, and I will be converting the this folder into a zip file. Okay, so I will be copying the address of this file and I will store it here. Okay, now the address of the zip file address. Okay, the address where this zip file will be stored or will be present after it is compressed, after this folder, unzip folder is compressed, and give it a name. Okay, that I am giving it a name, zipped folder dot set IP. Don't forget to give this extension, otherwise you will face error. Okay, now let's enter the parameters, compress file path and then zip file path. Now let's see what happens. See, this folder is zipped and it is stored here. Okay, it is on the desktop. So you can see that this is compressed and in the zip format. Now you can verify whether this folder has the same content as this original file. So you can see here, sorry, you can just tally. Excuse me, sorry. Okay, so you can compare here, you will find the same. So this was a small discussion or small video on how to extract a zip file and how to convert a or how to compress a folder into a zip file. So this is a very interesting video, and it is a very small video and it does not have much content in it. Okay. So you will really find it very useful because it does not involve much logic and anything. So it's just a simple thing. Okay. So I hope you have liked my video, and if you really liked my video, then please share and subscribe and give a thumbs up. And if you have some suggestions, then please mention the suggestion in the description box, sorry, on the comment box. Okay, and I'm really waiting here for your suggestions. Okay, and I have a couple of more videos which are very interesting, and I will mention the links in the description box. I hope you'll enjoy it and find it useful. So please subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up. Share it with your friends. Thank you. Thank you so much.